I'm by the busy road outside Pontypridd station. There's a train coming in up there in about 10 minutes time. It's a sad slash exciting day. It's the last day that a Pacer train is going to run in Britain. Let's go ride it. Pontypridd is a very pretty station. If you've never come and seen it, you should do that. Just got myself an All Lines Valley Day Ranger. I thought these to be like £7-8. It's 13 quid now. We're on platform 2. There's a train on its way down. It's 11:12 to Barry Island. I'm reliably informed that it's 143. Oh, it's pulling in now. 143 609 to Barry Island. Ta-da! Folding doors. And I pointed to the step as I got on, as that is one of the main reasons why these trains are going.
The first prototype Pacer, the Class 140, was built in 1980, with the others following later. But the Pacer was always meant to be a short-term solution, and when they had a longer lifespan than expected, opinion became very much divided as to whether they were worthy trains or not. With a reputation for being noisy, bouncy, and even leaky when it was raining, you probably disliked them if you were a regular commuter on them. But to other people, their quirks is what made them likable. It's PRM legislation that has finally caught up with them, though, with an earlier deadline that was pushed back to the end of May 2021, and so they can now no longer be used in passenger service.
I've got to subtitle this. I've never subtitled Welsh before. Great. Behind me, there's a man called Paul. You've got a bike down here. You're taking it seriously. What are you trying to do?
I'm trying to ride lots of old railway lines in South Wales and get the Pacers in between.
So overall, do you love Pacers or dislike Pacers? Would you give it a thumbs up or down?
I give them a thumbs up because they're lively, they're like a fairground ride. I call them HSTs, high screech trains.
What you've noticed in that last video clip is how Paul was bouncing around and I was bouncing around. This is what these trains do. They're very bouncy.
Yeah, they're stability, really.
And they're very noisy.
Yeah.
So I'm going to leave that bit of the video clip in just to show how noisy and bouncy it was.
Can we get into Krogan at 11:00?
This is Becca. Becca, are you from Cardiff?
No, I'm from the valley, further up there, I'm Dinesh.
How long have you been riding these cronky old trains?
Oh God, 24 years.
24 years? Are you glad that they're going?
Yes! Thank God, it's like Christmas come early.
We're coming out of Queen Street. We're going to go around Cardiff Central.
We will shortly be arriving at Cardiff Central.
It's about to
Thank
get
you.
Very squeaky.
Like we are now at Cogan.
So that's off to Barry. What I realised I could do is bow here at Cogan and walk 10 minutes down the road to Dingle Road and catch the one that's come up from Penarth up to Rhymney. So I tick both of them off and I get to tick off two stations as well. Double win. Dingle Road is going to come from that way and then head down that way to Penarth and back. So we were on 609. 609 apparently was the unit that was named Sir Tom Jones. You saved my life. Tom Jones. But this one is going to be 601, so there's two out today. So this will be picking up the second unit. And on to 601. Pulling into Penarth already. This one seems a lot less noisy, a lot less squeaky, a little bit cleaner, just seems nicer. 601, a better train than 609. I think it stands here for 4 minutes and then it goes round again. Slidey door time. Flappy door, not a slidey door, flappy door.
Well, I have to get
that one. I've met James, this is James. James, you just did a very nice thing and you helped that mother up with her child on the pushchair, and that's one of the big disadvantages of the pacer trains, isn't it?
Yes. And the lady was saying how much easier it would be after these have gone. But I like pacers.
You think I'd have a quick peek in the cab?
Yeah.
That's very kind. Thank you very much. Yeah. Technology from what, from the 1980s, right?
Yeah.
70s. They were only meant to be used for 20 years, and here we are in 2021.
They're built around the same time as the HST.
Flappy doors.
The journey is almost over for old trains, which means new trains are coming here in Wales on TFW. What is replacing the Pacers? The Pacers replacer in Wales. He's off camera now. I'm going to catch up with a comms officer from TFW, James Bennett, to talk about their new trains.
So we've got tram trains coming in on the Aberdare, Treherbert and Merthyr lines, and also the Flirts, which are very similar to the Greater Anglia ones. They'll be on the Rumney, Coryton, Ebbwvale and Maesteg lines. The whole complete fleet of new trains to replace the Pacers and the Sprinters when they go as well.
And what about the Viva Rail trains? When are those coming into the Bidston line?
So we're hoping to get those in later this year on the Wrexham Bidston line to take over again from Sprinters.
Also, did you arrange for the building works to be happening in the background specifically? That's really handy.
I didn't personally, but yeah, that's the new bus station for interchange between train and bus at Cardiff Central.
So even the background noise is transport related?
Yep, it's transport for wheels. Improving connectivity with public transport.
So we're off the Pacer and onto a Class 769, which I see because it is, or it was, and now it's converted as an old Thameslink Class 319 unit. They've been used by various operators and TFW are using them here. A diesel variant, you get bi-modes and tri-modes, but they're using it just as an interim until the new Stadler Flirt trains turn up in a couple of years' time. But with these low, comfortable seats, it's fun to be reminded of what I still see as an old Thameslink train. Quite frankly, this is a minor miracle. There's like a DMI, dot matrix, onboard indicator inside the train. When they were running as Thameslink trains in London, there was a great game you could play. There was a great game you could play at night in the winter called Guess Which Station I'm At, because there was no way of knowing. There was no PA, there was no dot matrix indicator, and often the stations many years ago weren't that well lit, so you were reliant on looking at your phone and the GPS position to work out if you're at Kentish Town yet or not. It's not like that now. So weird hearing it as a diesel and not an electric. We're at Hengoed, have I pronounced that correctly? The Pacer has been up to Rhymney, is on its way back south. So this will be it. This will be my last ever trip on a Pacer train back to Cardiff. No more. Whilst we wait for our train, we can't not come here, not come to the fact that there was an old railway line here. James, this is why we came here. You wanted to show me this old viaduct.
This is Hengoed Viaduct. It was on the old line between Pontypool and Neath, the Cross Valley line.
That's impressive. Anyway, last Pacer coming up. All right, it's due at 14:27. It's 14:25 now. This is it. This is going to be my last ever Pacer, which is here. I mean, it's running till 11 o'clock tonight. It's the last one that I'm going to get. 143601. So we're going to do flappy doors for the last time. We'll go to Cardiff and wave it off. Oh, that end.
My bus on it for the Cali Redwick Dutch of Nidia. Cumbrace is currently on time. Call it at.
Don't see many trains with wooden ladders on nowadays. I think it's what modern trains are missing, having a wooden ladder just out there. The other thing to point out is that these would have originally had the sort of the low back to the like bench style seats at some point during their life here in Wales, they've been converted to have the high back seats. For me, the classic pacer will still always be the 142 with the low star bench seats. This is it, last ever pacer. Our journey is almost at an end.
We will shortly be arriving at Plan Braddock.
So James is still with me. James is taking pictures. I will miss the flappy doors. I will miss these buttons. I'll miss the wooden step ladder. I won't miss the step down. Not having level boarding is not cool in 2021, and we welcome the new trains. Farewell, pacers. I'm gonna get out of Queen Street and we'll get a shot of it departing. It is running until 11 p.m. tonight, so I won't be on the very, very, very last one. Maybe you'll have been on the very, very last one up to Rhymney tonight. That's it, no more pacers.
We are now at Cardiff Queen Street.
Flappy doors. Here we go. Farewell, pacers. Thank you for the memories. Thank you for the bumpy rides. Thank you for the squeaking, squealing noises. Thank you for outlasting your 20 years that you were meant to originally run. But newer and better trains are coming. Farewell.